In January, federal water policy leaders gathered for a regional water summit at the Carlos M. Ramirez Tech H2O Water Resources Learning Center. As part of their visit to El Paso, Interior Secretary Ken Salazar and Bureau of Reclamation Commissioner Mike Connor also visited the K. Bailey Hutchison Desalination Plant.
We are seeing a number of things that are very important that really is putting this community at the forefront in terms of how we address water issues and water shortages.
Secretary Salazar lauded El Paso for diversifying its water portfolio to include river water, well water, reclaimed water, and desalinated groundwater. The Bureau of Reclamation manages rivers and lakes across the West. Commissioner Connor says Western cities that continue to rely exclusively on rivers and lakes as water sources should commit to diversifying, just as El Paso has done.
To come here and celebrate the successes of the El Paso water utilities and really transforming where they've been over the last decade, 10 to 15 years, and being a community on the edge with respect to water resources to one that has demonstrated such great leadership.
A key component of that leadership includes construction of the world's largest inland desalination plant. The plant can produce 27.5 million gallons of fresh, drinkable water every day. The desalination process allows El Paso water utilities to turn previously undrinkable brackish water from the Waco Bolson Aquifer into a clean, clear water resource for El Paso's future. Another key component, water conservation, which the Interior Secretary says is becoming a national model and nationally important as the dry La Nina weather pattern is expected to continue.
Across the country, people are looking to El Paso as a place in which they can learn by example.
Salazar and Connor also pledged to work with El Paso Water Utilities as it seeks funding to fuel the Hutchison plant using solar power.
You also see something here which I think is remarkable and a great example for the nation, and that's how you look forward to renewable energy as a way in which we will be able to power facilities like this.
So using one of the most plentiful resources in the Chihuahuan Desert to help find new sources of its most precious resource. For El Paso Water Utilities, I'm Martin Bartlett.